Okay, guys, so let's begin by solving this example 8. And here we're trying to find the actual magnitude of the velocity vector, right? VA. You can't just do, you know, VA cosine theta times, you know, T will give you 10 because you don't know T, right? And neither you can do it along the y direction. So is there any other things that we can use? Other equations that we have, for example? Okay, recall from exactly y is a function of x, right? Recall from last time, basically, acceleration x direction was zero, acceleration y was minus g. So we integrate those to find the velocities, and then we integrate the velocities to find the positions, right? And this is called a parametric equation, right? So when you have x as a function of t and then y as a function of t, this is a parametric. And can someone, when we take t and then get x, we can get y as a function of x. Can someone tell me, and does anyone still have the notes from last time?
T equal x of t over VA cosine 30. نحط محل t.
Right, but I
wanna... minus j x squared.
Minus g?
Yes, mm-hmm. x squared over 2v0 squared cosine theta squared.
Okay, wait, I think I also have it somewhere.
دكتور, مش عملنا غلط رحنا هون بالy of t?
No, why?
مش y of 0 isn't going to?
No, so what I said is what we do is we always put the frame basically at the center of the flight. Right?
بس انه اذا اذا ما نعمل هيك بتصير ما نعمل الهايت تبع هونيك بتصير 1 يعني مش 3.
Exactly, exactly, yes. Then you're going to use a relative you're going to use a relative difference basically.
Okay, but it's not wrong to put يعني y0 equal 2. بنشتغل طبيعي فيها.
Exactly, yes, yes, exactly. Okay. Then you have to put the initial boundary conditions, right? Okay, so my y as a function of x is equal to minus gx squared, right? 2 v0 squared cosine squared theta.
Plus tangent theta x.
Plus tangent theta x. Okay, guys, so we did that last time. So if I'm doing this, basically, remember when we did that, basically, we assumed x of 0. When you use this equation, you assume x of 0 is equal to what? Zero, مزبوط. And then you assume y of zero is equal to what? Zero, right? When we did that, basically, we had x of zero was zero, right? We didn't have any x zero here. My case, so when we took t, we didn't took x minus x zero divided by v zero cosine 30. We simply took t is equal to x divided by va cosine 30. So here we're assuming that. So when you use this equation, you have to, your projectile motion have to start at your launch point. So here, basically, the frame is literally here. Let me draw it for you guys. So, okay, I'm going to annotate here. And okay, so when you do this, basically, you're putting the frame here, right? This is your X, and now this is your Y. Okay, okay, so how can I find V0?
Replace Y by 0 and X by 0.
You replace Y by 0, X by 0. What do you get if you do that?
Class 0. Oh, 3 by 10? 1 by 10?
Yes, exactly. So y of 10 is equal to how much?
1.
1, mazboot. Y of 10 is equal to 1. Okay, so so this is what we did basically. We put the frame at the basket, right? Okay, let's do that. So what happens? So y of 10 is equal to 1. So we have 1 is equal to minus g x square 100 square. 100 squared divided by 2 v0 squared. What is cosine? Okay, cosine square of 30 plus tangent 30 multiplied by 10. Mazboot. So we can use this to find v0. You guys all agree? Or 1 is equal to minus 9.8. Okay, I had the x squared, so it's already 100. So 100 divided by 2. V0 squared. What is cosine 30? Square root of 3 over 2, right? Square plus tangent 30 times 10. Okay, so here you can use this to find V0 squared. All right, I'm not gonna sit down and solve it, but you guys are good. So let's say you were on an exam, right? Nowadays we're gonna be doing online exams. Online exams are easier. But let's say, you know, you are in the room, you know, you're sitting, you're trying to solve this problem, and then you solve V0, okay? And then you end up with V0 squared is equal to minus 5. Okay? When you are here, basically, you will start sweating, right, on the exam. Like, you know, how come you got V0 squared is equal to minus 5? And then you actually have to put the number. You have to put the answer. So some people will do this, will tell me, you know, V0 squared is equal, you put it like a complex number, and they tell me the number is imaginary. So it's equal to 5i, where I is a complex number per second. Some people just do this, like they don't continue. How would you guys do this? Can someone tell me? Like, what happened? Like, you're on the exam, you're trying to solve V0 squared. So here it's all like mass, right? If you end up with V0 squared to be a negative number, would you put this like a V0 is equal to a complex number times 5 meters per second, or you will just, you know, stop?
Isn't the minus indicating the sense or the direction?
Okay, but Santon, you're playing basketball, right? What would that mean, minus? Like you're trying to put the ball in the basket, right? And then you end up solving for V0 squared is equal to minus 5. You're looking at your friend's paper. He wrote this. He wrote like I, you know, I squared is equal to minus 1. You guys know the imaginary numbers, right?
Yes.
Okay, so what would you do there? What would you do in that situation?
Didn't reach the basket.
It can't reach the basket exactly. So it could be that.
Overshoot.
No, it's not an overshoot basically. So this is where you are, and then this is your basket, right? And then you're trying to solve for the velocity, right? So it could be that you are like unable to actually. So that velocity basically, no matter what velocity you put, you are unable to reach that point, right? And that could be, for example, like depending on where that is, right? So if your velocity is in that direction, maybe the target is like, you know, right below you, right? Or whatever. In this case, probably it won't happen, right? But ultimately, you know, in these problems, if you were ever trying to solve for the velocity and then you had velocity square and it was a negative number, then it means that the physics don't, you know, can't solve the problem basically, right? With any real number. Okay, so V0 squared is minus 5 is basically no matter what you do with a velocity, you will not be able to actually reach the value, right? But here that's not the case basically. If you solve this, obviously you're going to be able to get a number. Okay? Or it could be based on the actual angle that you have, based on the actual angle that we have, right? Let's say, so the basket is here, but your launch angle is below it. You guys see that? So let's say this is your launch angle and then this is your target, right? It may be impossible for, no matter how big the velocity is, you will not be able to actually reach that point. Okay, so your angle also has to kind of make sense, right? Your angle has to be kind of greater to be able to actually launch a projectile and then make it land there, right? Or even like kind of hit it. Are you guys good on this? Okay,
Doctor, so one question.
Yeah.
Last time you gave us the formula of the range and the height, maximum range and the maximum height.
Yeah.
فرضاً هون مثلاً الrange يحتسب 10.
Range بيحتسب 10. No, this is basically 10 is your literally like your coordinate, right? إلنا نحن range is what? So this is what I have from last time. The range is basically where your projectile movement start and then where it ends. So this is the range.
هون مش it ends when it in the basketball.
لا بتو تبعت
زي رايكوس تو. بتو تبعت exactly. Okay.
Yeah. أنا قلت إنه إذا عنا range نستعمل formula تبع range لأنه أهين وأسرع calculation.
Okay, but should actual equation of our range basically what
would be zero sine 2 alpha over g is on the bottom.
Yeah, but Santa Hone, you're not so Hone, okay, what is that range? The range was simply if you have okay, it's this basically, right? If you have some initial velocity and some angle, basically you can know how long or what is the distance of the projectile, right? You can use this if you said the basketball was in the same along the same horizontal line, right? In that case, and yes, you can say, okay, I have the range was both located the basketball here, and 10 was the distance of the basketball. Then you can use the range equation only in that case.
Okay.
Okay, guys. Any more questions on that, or are we good? Okay, so let's continue. okay, so let's go into, let me erase this. Okay, let's solve one more problem, basically. This is a problem that we have now. And in this problem, basically, we have this, this snowmobile, basically, which is traveling at 10 meters per second at the top of the slope. We would like to find the flight time that it takes for this guy to land at B. And they told us that the range here is R. How can we find the time of flight from A to B? And then also, we need to also solve for R. We just know the slope here. Can someone tell me how you would do this? Okay, guys. So, how would you solve this problem? So we know the initial angle was both. It's 10 meters per second, right? So we have projectile. Right.
دكتور مشتغل مثل قبل VAX VAY.
So we have the initial angle, we have the initial velocity 10 meters per second, right? And then we know the angle. It's 40 degrees. And okay, so it's gonna land here, right? And then this is kind of like your slope, right? They actually told you that this distance right there is your range. Okay. And that slope here is basically what, 4, 3, and then 5. Okay, how can I find the R?
Doctor, أول شيء بعمل مثل عمل بلشنا هونيك بعمل VAX و VAY مع ال initial position. يعني عندي ال VAX.
Okay, so look, if you do VAX, what is VAX is gonna be equal to 10 cosine 40. That's good.
So,
and what is x of t is equal to 10 cosine 40 times t. Okay, so how would that help you to find r? Okay, let's say r is
equal to... R is x 2 t1.
T1. So we had time 1 t1, that's good. Okay, so how would you find t1? You don't even know r. We don't actually have r. Okay,
so we assume x is 2t1. Y in function of r.
What is it?
We assume that x is equal to r. From the slope, we get y in function of r.
We assume y to be a function of r, okay. And from the slope, we get y as a function of r. Exactly, yes. This is what we do. Okay, so here again, we can write this as a, we can put our frame again here on the bubble. So this is my x and then y. Mazboot. Okay. What is y of r, guys? Can someone tell me what is y of r? So if x is equal to r, what is y? It's going to be equal to this value, Sheikh. Well, that's me h. Sheikh, y of r is equal to how much? What is y of r, guys? What is the y value for the projectile when x is equal to r? And when x is equal to r, what is the y? value.
Some height is doctor.
مش h.
Yes. Tangent.
H.
The angle.
H. لا h basically. So هون we're starting obviously from the top. Right. So y of r is equal to h. You guys agree?
Yes, yes, yes.
H or minus h?
Minus h.
Okay, so be careful, okay, on the exam. Don't make silly mistakes like that, okay? Y of r is minus h because this is my origin right here. Okay, good. Tayyib, what is, so can I actually write what is y of r? Based on the equation that we have, مزبوط, we have minus gx squared, right? So minus gx squared, شو x squared would say r squared, مزبوط? Minus gr squared divided by 2 v0 squared cosine squared theta plus tangent theta times r. Do you guys agree? Is this true or no?
Yes, true.
Okay, so this guy is equal to how much? Minus h, مزبوط?
لحظة دكتور، هي تانجنت تاتا تي ولا تانجنت تاتا اكس؟
تانجنت تاتا اكس، ما هيك بس هون اكس is equal to r.
Why of r? Yeah, okay. Yes.
Is equal to, okay, is there any relationship between r and h?
مش h is equal to tangent تبع يعني 3 over 4 times r.
Exactly, right? So نحن هون we know 4, مش هيك 4 over r. Is equal to what? Similar triangle. 3 over h. 3 over h. Is it minus h one or positive h?
No, I had the distance on
positive
h.
How on it? Positive or negative?
Positive.
Why?
No distance. I'm just doing direction.
Must vote. Absolute distance. Okay, so be careful on it. So, how can I solve for r?
H equals 3 over 4 times r.
Exactly. So minus g r squared divided by 2 v0 squared cosine squared theta plus tangent theta r is equal to minus h. Shuhil minus h minus 3 over 4 r. Was good? Okay. So now I can solve for r basically. I can kind of...
divide by r al maltain. Yes.
All right. And then I can do... And then you guys can take it from here, or should I solve it for you more? Let me solve it.
It's okay.
So you have tangent theta plus 3 over 4 is equal to g divided by 2 v0 squared cosine squared theta multiplied by r, as both. And then you can solve for r here. Okay, I'm going to let you guys do the rest.
Dr. Andy, so ill. The r, كتبناها فوق, مش هي بتكون 10 cosine 40 times 2t. One.
Here.
لا فوق ال equation تبع الار.
Here.
لا فوق بعد. هاي r equal 10 cosine 40. مش times 2t1.
Times t1.
بس ما بال equation أنا ذكرها هي 2t1 حتى نا. X 2t1.
هذه كانت parabola أو same شو اسمه غير situation.
Oh, okay. So we use 2t1. Oh, no. Okay, so I think 2t1, basically, we had a projectile, مزبوط. And the time on it is t1. And then we have a symmetric. And then we become 2t1.
Yes, sir.
And we know the velocity is constant, so we multiply it by 2t1 and then give height distance.
طبعا هاي أساس هم كانت 10 cosine 40t1. ليش على قد يعني؟ ليه مش ما بعرف. ليه مش 10 cosine 40t1 over 3 مثلا أو times 3 أو اللي هي يعني.
Okay. Shoot. So what? Okay. So R here distance must both in x direction.
So.
Okay. So to get the distance, you're integrating the velocity in x direction, right? What is your velocity in x direction?
10 cosine 40 t.
No, the velocity is 10 cosine 40. And that's it.
The velocity. Yeah, okay.
So your distance is you integrate it, right?
So.
So, نحن جبنا الx of t basically أول شيء. جبنا الx of t sin cosine 40 t, right? And then in the r here, what x of x of time t1, whatever time t1. Okay. We didn't use the time t1. So, the x, the r here x of time t1 which is then for 10 cosine 40 basically times t1. So basically
times t1, okay.
Does it make sense or no?
Yes, yes. Okay, thank you. Great.
Make sure you do the assignments, okay? Make sure you are doing the assignments. Okay, the second thing is how can I find the time of flight? After that, I have r. How can I find t?
How can place I... an r is equal to 10 cosine 40 t1.
Mazbut, exactly. So we'll use this equation, check. So once you calculate r, once you calculate r from here, right, we can find t1, right? So r is equal to 10 cosine 40 t1. So t1 is going to be equal to how much? R divided by 10 cosine 40. Is that all clear, guys, how we're doing these problems?
Yes, yes.
If I ask you, if I ask you to find the velocity of this person, basically, the actual magnitude of the velocity at B, and I'm gonna actually pick up on someone, and I'm gonna ask someone else that is what I'm seeing. So I'm gonna ask Reynaldo Al-Asmar. Reynaldo Al-Asmar, can you open your mic?
Yes, doctor.
Yeah, how can you find the velocity of this person at point B?
DOS.
Yeah, how can you find the magnitude of the projectile, right, of the person at point B? We need to know the actual magnitude.
مش نحن عنا جبنا ال R مش نعملها نعملها integrated مرة مرتين لأنه هي ال V كلها.
ال R هي ال basic okay ال R هي ال position right? If you are integrating the position, what do you can what do you get if you integrate the position? Get nothing, right? You get something that has no physical representation.
Derivative, sorry, derivative.
Mazboot, okay. Derivative, sorry. But you have the velocity in x direction. Okay, let's see. Let me see. I have. Okay.
Doctor, بس فيك تعيد السؤال, please.
Okay, I'm asking like, what? How can you find the velocity of the projectile at point B? نحن هلا جبنا the flight time وجبنا the range. I'm asking you find the magnitude of the velocity of the projectile.
Can we answer? Or...
Yeah, let me ask one more person. Jad Atalla.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm trying to find the velocity of the projectile at point B.
Doctor, do we use H to find it? Should we use H to find it?
No, okay, so انت هون, you're trying to find the velocity at point B, مزبوط. Okay, what is the actual equation for the velocity, مزبوط? So the velocity of a projectile, نحن بالكورس, it will have an X component, it will have a Y component, ما هيك؟ Can you tell me شو velocity in X direction? Right, Jad. What is the velocity in x direction?
Isn't it v times cosine the angle of at this point?
مزبوط. Okay, so v zero cosine 40. ما هيك؟ Okay, شو velocity?
Okay, right.
شو velocity in the y?
V zero sine 40 minus gt.
Minus gt. مزبوط. Okay, so هاي the velocity in the y is depends on time, okay? Shall velocity at point B, what should I, how can I find the velocity? So the velocity on it changes with time. Is it time zero? Okay, it's going to be equal to that, but is it time minus zero? It will depend on this, on the gravity, right? What would be the velocity in the y direction when you reach B? Just replace t by t1, but we already
saw t1. Yes, right. So we just found t1. So we replace it here.
مزبوط. So جبنا ال vy at b. مزبوط. عملها هيك at b. Okay. طيب, what is the magnitude of the velocity vector at b?
It's v radical of v zero squared cosine 40 squared.
It's v squared, okay? Plus.
Yes, yes, and vy b squared.
Okay, so remember, vy is always depends on t. Okay, guys. Oh, okay, guys. So that is it. How you find the velocity? What happens if you throw this like in space as a Murphy G? What would be? How would you solve that? Like, what would happen if you were throwing this projectile in space? What would be Vy?
In space, ما راح يكون في motion مثل هون. ما في gravity الآن.
How is that? No. What changes? What changes here if you throw this in space?
Vy would be constant, but delta is zero sine 40.
Exactly right. And G would be zero, right? Okay, guys. So we're done for today. We have like 8 more minutes, but we will not have time because I want to start kind of like a new topic. Or actually, that is it regarding now. I'm gonna close this session, and then I'm gonna open another session so we can talk for another 10 minutes, and we're gonna talk about centrifugal acceleration, etc. Okay, guys. So log back into the same meeting.